Can a moon have a moon? Well, yes, in theory it can. And yet, we don't see any examples of this in our solar system. So why is that? The first important thing to know is that all celestial objects have gravitational pull. That includes tiny little asteroids, all the way to giant stars or even black holes. The mass of an object dictates how strong its gravitational pull is. A region around an object where its gravitational influence is greater than any other celestial object near them is called its Hill sphere. Due to the mass of our Earth, it has a Hill sphere which has a radius of 1.5 million kilometers, meaning that if you were within this Hill sphere, you would be pulled more towards Earth than towards the Sun. If the Earth was closer to the Sun, its Hill sphere would be smaller, and if it was further away, it would be larger. The Sun also has its own Hill sphere, which contains the entire solar system. Its Hill sphere is massive, almost 2 light-years radius, as the nearest celestial object its gravity is competing against are other stars. Which means, in a way, everything orbiting our Sun is the Sun's moon, or rather, its satellite. The term moon is really reserved for satellites of planets. So why don't moons also have natural satellites? Well, lots of moons are extremely close to their parent planets, meaning their Hill spheres are very small. Let's take our moon as an example. Against the Earth, the Hill sphere of the moon is only 60,000 kilometers radius, or only 1/6 of the distance from the moon to the Earth. Moons like Io have an even smaller Hill sphere, as it is competing against the gravity of Jupiter. This makes it quite hard for moons to capture an object, but not technically impossible. So surely there must be a moon that has a natural satellite somewhere, right? Well, most moons also have one other major problem. They tend to be tidally locked to their parent planet. Because of this, any satellite that orbits a tidally locked object will have its orbit decay from tidal forces until it eventually crashes into the moon. Now, this still takes a lot of time over astronomical standards, but it means if any of the moons in our solar system did have a satellite at one point, chances are that it has since crashed into it. This leaves one question, I think. Why don't moons of planets also eventually crash? The difference is that none of our planets are tidally locked to the Sun, as they are far enough away from the parent star, which means their moons have a stable orbit. This is one of the reasons we believe that none of the TRAPPIST system planets have moons, as they are so close to their parent star that we assume the planets are all tidally locked. I hope this didn't disappoint you too much, so I'm going to leave you with this. There are some other curious objects in the solar system, far away from any other object, so that they aren't tidally locked to anything. This particular asteroid, called Ida, looks like a standard 30 km wide asteroid as seen by the Galileo spacecraft, but you might notice this little blob here. This is actually Ida's moon, Dactyl. It's only 1.5 km across and orbits only 60 km away from Ida. We don't know especially how stable this orbit is, but a very cool thing to observe nonetheless. Well, thanks for watching, and thanks for all your support with the channel, no matter how small. I love making these videos and learning more in the process. It really is a joy to be running this channel. If you're new, why not subscribe so you don't miss out on any space videos in the future? All the best, and I'll see you next time.